Well, I want to thank everyone for coming. Happy and healthy New Year. This is our first official press conference in the new year for the IDC. And I want to thank you for coming here today. Today is something that I think highlights a very, very important issue and something that all of us here are going to make our priorities. Really, what we can do to change New York's hostile business climate to a business-friendly climate. And the focus is really going to be on small businesses. Just the way of background, one of the things that the Independent Democratic Conference has kicked off last summer, which has been really wildly successful, is our thought raiser concept. What we wanted to do is meet with individual businesses, constituents, different groups in our respective Senate districts to sort of hear what they have to say. And the first focus was small businesses. This really came out of, I think, all of us realizing that a lot of the legislation that we pass over the years really comes out of our constituents, from our districts. I know I've passed numerous pieces of legislation which had a statewide effect on businesses, on individual constituents, and it really came out of a one-on-one meeting with one of my constituents. And we thought that the same process can be applied to individual groups, especially small businesses. Small businesses in Rockland County, small businesses in Orange County, Central New York, Staten Island and Brooklyn, and of course in my district in Bronx and Westchester, really face the same problems, especially during these tough economic times. We all know that earlier this month, Governor Cuomo put out his new initiative declaring New York open for business. I'm very excited about that, all of us are, and I think, though, it's important for us to focus on those businesses, those small businesses that endured this tough economic downturn in our economy and were able to prosper, or at least attempt to prosper. I think, you know, we owe a debt of gratitude to them, so I think it's important we take a good hard look at some of the things that impact them. Altogether, we met with 75 small businesses. We asked them to actually fill out a very brief questionnaire rating what's some of the obstacles that they face in conducting their business on a daily basis. And I don't think the results were earth-shattering, but at the same time, we did recognize a distinct trend on some of the things that are very important. When I say not earth-shattering, I think we knew what a lot of their problems are. But I think now, moving forward, we're going to take a good hard look at some of those things and really make that our priority as far as our legislative agenda is concerned. First and foremost was health care costs. That ranked number one. Second were taxes and fees. And third was access to credit. You know, these are things that I think some of the priorities that we can move forward and we can actually accomplish things and do some real important things to help small business. I think one of the problems with the failure in our present economic situation here in New York State and probably nationally is not doing enough for small business, not recognizing that small businesses is what generates our economy. Small business is responsible for generating the most jobs. So if we can take a good hard look at some of the things that concern small businesses, I think we can very easily, in a short period of time, jumpstart our economy. And I think we're really suited to look into these things because Senator Carlucci is the chair of the Administrative Regulation and Review Commission. So we're going to be taking a look at things like that, you know, those burdens that people shake their head and say, hey, you know, why do we do this to small business on a daily basis? But my colleagues here today are going to be discussing the 3 points that we highlighted. First, Senator Savino is going to talk about health care.
Thank you, Senator Klein. You know, Senator Klein said we've spent a lot of time over the past few months meeting with small businesses in our communities, upstate, downstate, and the overarching theme among all of them was, whether you were a butcher, a baker, or a candlestick maker, the cost of health care and the cost of health insurance in New York State has skyrocketed 50 to 100% in the past 10 years. We all know that the cost of health insurance has also acted as a wage depressant on working people across the state, either in increased copays out of the pockets of hardworking New Yorkers, or out of increased costs, which makes employers have to defer investing in their employees with salary increases. Something has to be done. But in addition to the cost going up, a lot of the small businesses are very concerned about the future of the federal health care reform program and what it means to them and what it means to New York State. Now, we know that in 2014, small businesses are going to be able to purchase coverage through a health insurance exchange. Whether it's implemented by New York or whether it's instituted upon us by the federal government, we hope that we're going to be able to adopt and create a health care exchange program right here in New York State. We believe that this insurance exchange presents a tremendous opportunity to provide benefits to uninsured New Yorkers and to drive down the cost for small businesses. In order to do that, we have to make sure that we fully capitalize on this opportunity. And we believe that the exchange has to do three things. First, it has to provide small business purchasers with the greatest number of insurance plan options. We need healthcare plans that reflect the same diversity in scope and size as the businesses in this state. Second, we need to give small businesses a seat at the table when we determine which types of plans should be made available. We need to give them affordable options so that all businesses will have the opportunity to participate. And finally, we have to empower small businesses to choose the plan that works best for their needs and the needs of their business and their employees. If we give everybody the opportunity to participate, we can drive down the cost, we can ensure that all New Yorkers are receiving quality health care, and we can do something finally for small businesses who have been asking for assistance in this area for a very long time. Now I'd like to introduce Senator Carlucci, who's going to talk about the regulatory burden and taxes and fees that small businesses face.
Well, thank you, Senator Savino. And I just wanted to reiterate what was talked about, Senator Klein had mentioned, that small businesses are really the backbone of the American economy. And any way that we can expand the ranks of the businesses, the small businesses in New York, will expand the ranks of the middle class. And that's what's going to be so important to make sure the economic engine in New York is running and it's flourishing. Now, before I came to the New York State Senate, I served as the town clerk in the town of Clarkstown. And I had the great honor of helping people with all types of issues and problems. And one of the things that I remember most was when someone wanted to start a business. They'd come into my office and they were so excited. They had this great idea. And, you know, it wasn't rocket science, but it was some idea. And over again, it was the same thing. You know, they were so happy to start this business and really tap that entrepreneurial spirit that's made America what it is. And then I'd say, oh, okay, well, you want to do this? Well, you got to call this agency and then that agency, and there's this permit and that form and this regulation that you have to follow. That's the problem that's really hindering the economic spirit in New York State. And I have the privilege to chair the Administrative Regulations Review Commission. And it's something that I think that if we do right, we can turn the ship around and make sure that businesses are flourishing in New York. Just this past legislative session, we passed a bill that I call the Small Business Cure Period Bill. We passed it through the Senate. We got it on the governor's desk. He signed it into law. And what that does is it really changes the climate in New York. And it makes it that businesses work with state agencies and vice versa. So now if a regulation is promulgated, instead of the small business getting slapped with a fine, the state agencies have to work with that small business to bring them into compliance. So it's really changing that climate to make sure that small business and government are on the same page, on the same team, working together. And over the past few months, we've had these thought raisers, and we've heard the same thing over and over again. And a lot of it has to do with the regulations, just regulations that are being thought of here in Albany that go down to Main Street in New City or in the Bronx or Staten Island or Syracuse, and not having anything to do or not having the experience of walking in the shoes of that small business owner. And let me be clear, the small businesses that we've talked to and that we deal with understand the importance of regulations, understand the importance of making sure that their employees are safe, their customers are safe. And it's about working together to make sure that the right regulations are implemented. And there are a couple areas that we believe that we can really focus in on over this legislative session. Number one is to review and investigate all redundant regulations. And the second is to make sure that we set up additional safeguards so that when legislation is passed, that it's taken into effect or taken into account what the regulatory climate is dealing with that subject. And then the other issue that's extremely important that we heard over and over again are the taxes and fees that are levied on small businesses. And one in particular, one of the major problems that we have here in New York is that we have some of the highest utility rates in the nation. And a good portion of that is because we have one of the highest or the heaviest energy taxing states in the nation. And typically, a small business owner, their utility bill, about 25% of that is taxes. So we believe that we can really try to hammer away at the hidden fees and taxes that are levied in utility bills. Just for example, the average business owner is paying 52% more in utility rates than their neighbors in neighboring states. That's putting small businesses in New York at a competitive disadvantage, and we've got to fight that. So what we pledge to do is to review all hidden taxes and fees within our utility bills. That's something that'll go a long way to help small businesses thrive in New York. And finally, by implementing and taking advantage of tax credits in certain areas, we believe we can really help ignite the small businesses to flourish in New York. And it's very simple. When we relieve the burden on small businesses, it allows them to expand. When small businesses expand, they create jobs. And when jobs are created, we're putting New Yorkers to work. So with that, I want to introduce Senator Valesky.
Thank you, Senator Carlucci. I'm going to talk about some recommendations that we have in regard to access to credit. But before I do that, I just want to pick up on what David had said in regard to taxes and fees and not doing taxes and fees, which is so important. I heard, and I know my colleagues heard at these thought raisers, these were administered after session was over last year, but the reflection on last year's session, small business owners understood the importance, for example, of doing that tax cap, something that we've been fighting for years. They understood the importance that we here in Albany were getting our fiscal house in order, that last year we were balancing a $10 billion budget deficit without doing new taxes, without doing new fees. So the effort to improve the overall business climate certainly began last session, and we are anxious to continue that into this year. And I certainly was very pleased yesterday in Governor Cuomo's second budget presentation to once again hear no new taxes in the new budget proposal, no new fees. And I know small business owners appreciate that as well. One of the things that many of them had indicated to all of us is this issue of credit. And the issue of access to credit, you know, is, I think, directly a result of the national economic recession. This is something that has not been a problem year after year after year. It's only been in recent years. So obviously, we have to do something. Last summer, the federal government made certain resources available, and Governor Cuomo authorized the use of those federal funds to the tune of about $55 million to help small businesses. But we have to make sure that those dollars are going to businesses who need them and need that access to credit. So three things that we'll be proposing this legislative session. First, we will propose an email notification system that would allow businesses to sign up for an immediate notification of programs that could benefit them. So often here in Albany, we create programs and there's a disconnect between what we do in Albany and small businesses back home. We need to shorten that time frame significantly. We think an email notification system, anyone can sign up so that as soon as something is done here that can be helpful to them, an email will go out notifying them of that change in law. Second, we're going to investigate whether we can streamline government incentive programs so that the lag time between a business participating in a program and receiving the benefits from that program are shortened. Again, the length of time that government often takes to deliver those benefits can be far too long. So we want to see how we can shorten that time period. And third, we're talking about, and hopefully we'll be advancing in bill form very soon, the possibility of a government-backed revolving line of credit program that would be administered by the banks that would be accessible to small businesses in good standing in New York. We think that this is a way that we can improve the situation and make sure that a credit is available to small businesses who need them. We also heard about licensing issues, permit issues, application procedures that just take too long. In the business world, things have to happen quickly, and I think government has to be able to respond just as quickly to be of assistance wherever we can. So, plenty of work for the four of us to do as the Independent Democratic Conference, and we intend to do just that in helping to make New York a business-friendly state as we proceed through the session. So, anyone with questions I'll be glad to take them.
Senator, I'll leave you in a good place. In your experience dealing with business entrepreneurs as they're starting up, did you get the impression that they felt the state was too focused on the big players, on the big corporations, like this Buffalo idea, and not?
Exactly. That's it. And that's why this cure period bill was so important. Because the big businesses can afford the lobbyists. They can afford the lawyers. It's the small mom-and-pop shops. It's that person with the dream, with a few dollars in their pocket. They don't have access to the lobbyists and to a lot of the people that are making the regulations in the agencies. So that's why we're really focused on the small businesses, because we need to harness that entrepreneurial spirit here in New York and make sure that people will continue to come here to New York. And we reclaim that empire state that we were, that people, when they have a dream, when they have an idea, we want them to come to New York so their dream can and their business can flourish.
Well, thank you all very much.
Thank you.